Oh, ooh, you're a feisty little guy, too. What's your problem? Remember last time I had you try to bite me as well. Oh, what are you doing, buddy? So anyways, I'm gonna go ahead. Hey, good morning, everybody. Welcome to the vlog. I hope the start of your day is absolutely incredible. We have kind of a little bit of an update kind of vlog here today. In the way, I mean, we're gonna have a bunch of baby ball pythons that just hatched. Remember, I cut some clutches. Well, they're out, so I'm gonna update you on that. I'm gonna update you on Helen, because we fed her yesterday, as well as the one-eyed, see if they ate. I'm gonna update you on that really cool scaleless Texas rat snake. We have a couple cool celebrations that we're gonna celebrate. Today is just gonna be absolutely incredible, and I hope that your day is amazing too. I think that we should make it awesome together. Can you do me one favor and hit that like button right now? Let's try to get this video to say 7,000 or 8,000 likes. And if you do that, I'll do something really special in the next couple days. So go ahead and smash it. Also, I want you guys to comment down below about if you had a dream animal, any animal that you had. I mean, I don't even care if it's a rhino or an elephant or a lion or whatever it might be. Comment down below. Let me know what that animal is. I'm going to go ahead and run around and ask the crew what their dream animal is. As far as me, I've always loved giraffes. I love giraffes, but you know, I love everything. I'd like a great white shark. I'd like a giraffe. I'd like a rhino. I would like a Komodo dragon, for gosh sake. So don't ask me what my favorite animals, because I will have a million things for you guys. Regardless, let's go ahead and get this day started and let's make it amazing. So before I get my day started, we actually offered food to Helen and the one-eyed snake. So I'm gonna go ahead and check to see if they ate. I've been assist feeding them the last few weeks, so fingers crossed that they ate, but I have a feeling I might be in for a little battle here. But hey, you never know. Let's go ahead and see. Come on, Helen. Did you eat? Where's your food? There's still something in there, so that one didn't eat. Let's go ahead and check the one-eyed. Nope, that didn't eat. And finally, let's see, this one, I don't know, maybe this one ate. Oh, nope, that didn't eat either. So that's a bummer. You know, I had high hopes, but again, I'm not giving up on her. I know she's gonna get going. She looks completely fine and healthy. She hasn't been losing any weight. She has great tongue response. She moves around great. Same with the one-eyed. So again, it's just one of those things that you have to stay persistent. If you give up on them, then that's really not doing them justice. I know she's gonna get going. I'll just continue to assist feed her till she finally eats. As for now, I'm gonna go ahead and check out those baby ball pythons that just crawled out of the egg. All right, so let's go ahead and get into some cool little baby hatchling ball pythons. We had a handful of clutches that I caught the other day that crawled out of their eggs, and I want to show you what the kind of fruits of our labors are. Now, this first clutch was actually interesting because it was actually a silver streak that was bred to a lemon blast, which is basically just a whole bunch of like pastel, pinstripe, cinnamon, all kinds of other stuff. And we actually kind of missed on a lot of this stuff. We did produce some lemon blasts right here, which are just basically pastel pinstripe. But other than that, we only hit one animal that was kind of a cool combination. And that's this one right here, which is basically a pewter pinstripe, which is a pastel, a cinnamon, and a pinstripe. Now, it's a really beautiful animal, but we definitely didn't hit a lot of the super stuff, and we had a bunch of normal stuff, so this clutch was a little bit of a miss. But listen, I don't complain, because again, when you hit odds, it's great. When you miss odds, you gotta just say, hey, I'm gonna hit the odds on the next one, because after all, they're odds, and they all even out over time. But anyway, still some really beautiful babies here, just not the kind of mother load when it comes to really cool mutations. Now, this next clutch was actually a yellow belly bred to a pastel ivory. Now, a pastel ivory is essentially a white snake that is a super version of yellow belly. This is what a yellow belly looks like right here. And you can kind of see that the belly looks a little bit different than a normal ball python, and they have those really cool flames up the sides. Now, the super version, again, is an ivory, an all-white snake. And then, of course, a pastel would be a pastel version of that. And this right here would just be the ivory ball python, which is the super yellow belly. And again, that's just a white snake. It's another form of white snake, but it's not related to the blue-eyed leucistics, which are much whiter. But this was actually the first white snake that came into the country out of West Africa. So it was kind of the first real leucistic ball python. Although now we don't really think of them as leucistics because we have the blue-eyed and the black-eyed leucistics, which are much more white. And then, of course, we have this here, which is the pastel ivory, which is just a little bit different. You can see its head pattern is just a little bit more clear, and it's just a little brighter. And when these guys get older, they definitely are much more white than the normal normal ivory. So that's basically it. We got some pastel ivories and some ivories from this clutch. But again, because it was a super, which was the pastel ivory, all of the babies are gonna be at least yellow belly. All right, so now the next two clutches were a little bit more exciting. Kelsey kind of surprised me by breeding a Lori to a champagne, or actually a mimosa, which means a ghost champagne. I didn't even know she did the breeding, so when she produced eggs, she kind of surprised me with it, which I love the fact that she did that. And here's basically the result right here. This is a Lori ball python, champagne ball python. And to the best of my knowledge, this is the very first Lori champagne that's ever produced. And it basically just makes the pattern a little bit more kind of sooty looking. So I'm interested to see when we start getting this into other mutations that Lori balls do really well with, what they're gonna look like. And here's its sibling here. This one is really interesting looking too. Again, this is another Lori champagne. Now you guys may ask yourself, why is it called a Lori ball python? I've told this story before, but maybe you're a new viewer to the vlog and you didn't know. Lori actually, believe it or not, had pulled aside a couple ball pythons from an African shipment and said, these are really pretty. And so we just marked on the cage, keep Lori. Well, over the next year or so, people were coming to see the Lori balls, which look just like this. Basically, it's a black-backed animal, and it's a little bit of a muted animal as well. And what happened was people started to calling them Lori balls because that's what they were marked on the cage, never thinking that that was gonna stick. We always intended on eventually naming them something else. Well, regardless, we raised those up and we bred them together and we produced a super Lori, which was absolutely incredible looking, and the name stuck. So there you have it. There's the Lori ball story, and now you've got some Lori ball champagnes. And finally, there was the last clutch that I cut that was a fire red stripe yellow belly bred to a pastel GHI. I tell you what, some of these animals came out pretty interesting. And this one right here is what the mom looked like. This is a fire red stripe yellow belly. But what's interesting is I think that these other two animals that hatched out, which are really interesting looking, I mean, take a look at those patterns. Now, I'm not sure if that's like somehow a GHI mix or if it's like an allelic animal so that when you breed a GHI to a red stripe, you get this really goofy color and pattern. I'm not 100% sure. They look like they have fire in them and they look like they have yellow belly and certainly a red stripe, but there's something else going on and I'm not really sure what it is. Regardless, I couldn't be more excited about these guys. I think I'm gonna have to raise these guys up and breed them out to see what they are. Are they GHI? Are there something different going on? Because I've never seen anything like it. And I absolutely love these guys. I mean, take a look at those things, man. Aren't they crazy? So I asked you earlier to comment down below what your dream animal would be. Anything that you possibly want. Now I'm going to turn the tables and ask my crew. All right, Eric, what is your dream animal?
That's a really tough question. I'm gonna have to say the king cobra.
King cobra?
Oh yeah.
Woo-hoo-hoo. King cobras are amazing. I've been very fortunate to play with a handful of them. They are so intelligent.
I hope I get to, but now with Mary, probably not. Dreams right down the drain, right?
Never give up that dream, never give up. All right, I'm on a mission. I am gonna take Eric and we're gonna go play with king cobras. As a matter of fact, a friend of mine here in Michigan actually has a king cobra, believe it or not. So we'll try to see if we can get over and play with them. I'm sure you guys would like to see us play with a king cobra too. So king cobra,
good one, I like it.
I wanted to continue my update spree for you. Remember that really cool scaleless Texas rat snake that we hatched out that I was like, oh my God, I don't even know what this is. I wanted to show you now that it's shed and it's got a little bigger. And we actually have another one that's pretty interesting. I want to show you that. I think it's going to be the perfect pairing. That one was a female and we hatched a male from a completely unrelated clutch that I think I'm going to raise up and breed together. Anyways, let's go ahead and look at these. This is that one. Oh my gosh. Take a look at how crazy that thing is. Have you guys ever seen a snake that looked like a, I mean, look at the white splotching that's coming through. That thing is absolutely amazing, isn't it? So I think this is gonna be really cool. The thing that I don't know is like, what is it? Like, it's a mutation that's just bizarre. I mean, it's like so beautiful and it's got like these white patches. Oh, you're a feisty little guy too. What's your problem? Remember last time I had him out, he was trying to bite me as well. Oh, what are you doing, buddy? So anyways, I gotta go ahead and make sure that I set this one up and raise up. Again, this is a female right here. Let's go ahead and take a look at the male that I think is gonna be the perfect pairing. Now, it's not nearly as neat as that female, but look at the size. Look at the white pattern on the sides. It's this crazy, like, white-sided animal. Now, there are white-sided black rats. There's really no white-sided mutation in Texas rats, so I'm not even 100% sure what's going on here, but this is a male and that's a female, so I think the pairing of those two together are gonna be absolutely incredible. incredible. So again, what do you guys think about that? I mean, look at how amazing that is. And again, his girlfriend looks like right here. Look at the two together. Oh, that is gonna be such an awesome pairing. And for you guys that don't know, it's gonna take about 2 years to raise them up and breed them. So hey, that's the labor of love. You just gotta take your patience. But before you know it, it'll be a snap of the fingers. These guys will be 2 years old and we'll have some eggs and hopefully prove out some really incredible little babies. And you're so feisty. What is up with you?
I love those guys.
All right, now on to Jessica. Jessica, your dream animal.
Oh. Fruit bat or an owl of some kind.
What?
Yeah.
I would not expect it to be a dream animal. Fruit bat or an owl. Okay. I like it. And listen, I actually really love fruit bats, so they're super cool. Owls are awesome too, you know? So although I was a little bit surprised by her answer, I think that's awesome. All right, so I'm going to catch up with Jessica later to look at some cool geckos because she's putting away geckos, right?
Yep. Got lots of cool stuff today.
All right. Fruit bats and owls. So I am down in the dungeon, of course, and I've got Mary and Kelsey. All right, I'm gonna do it together, right? All right, dream animal, what do you got?
Dream animal, killer whale.
Oh my gosh, Shamu! The killer whales, I mean, they are amazing. They really are. And I know that there's all that controversy with SeaWorld and Blackfish and all that stuff. The truth is, the killer whales are amazing animals, and I don't even wanna touch the whole SeaWorld thing. Let's leave it there, okay? Mary, what is your dream animal?
A German giant bearded dragon.
A German giant beard. These guys are throwing stuff out at me that I absolutely was not prepared for. I was thinking stuff like, oh, they're gonna say, oh, I want a cheetah or I want a giraffe. And they're throwing out German giant bearded dragons and killer whales and fruit bats and, oh my God, you guys are absolutely awesome. Well, you know, at least your dream animal is very obtainable.
Yes.
Kelsey, you're gonna need a bigger bathtub. I don't think a killer whale is gonna fit where she has things. But hey, you keep dreaming, girls, keep dreaming. Go ahead down in the comments and let me know what your dream animal is, whatever it is. It could be a German bearded dragon, it could be a killer whale, it could be a fruit bat, whatever you want. You guys know I love giraffes, but I love everything. So I can't wait to read your comments and see what you guys tell me. As promised, I'm checking back in with Jessica to see what kind of gecko she has for us today. So what do you have?
Check this out.
What is it? It looks like it's gotta have Max Snow Tremper in it, right? Or?
Yes, and a clip.
Wow, that thing is crazy cool. Wow, jeez.
That thing is just, it's gonna be hard to top that one. That one kind of blew me away.
Look at this radar.
Oh my gosh, look at the pink eyes on that one. Oh my gosh, that thing is crazy. And again, the radar is the same thing as a raptor, but in the bell version, right?
Okay. That is correct.
I want to make sure I got my facts right before I go up on that.
Oh, wow, look at that. That's just a bold snow, or what is that?
It's a bold snow eclipse.
It's a bold?
Yep. Oh. They're so adorable.
There's nothing cuter than a little tiny gecko that's like, I'm going to bite you. I'm going to take on. It's so amazing.
Really good striped bold snow.
And the bold snows have always been kind of one of my favorites. I just love that patterning, and then you get into the white and yellow too. So
our stripes have been getting better every year, I think.
It's continued.
And that's, the stripe is like a polygenic trait, so this every year you breed the best stripe to the best stripe, and you keep getting better and better and better.
Oh, look at the color on that. Oh my gosh.
I don't know if you guys could tell on camera, but it's like super bright in person.
As always, I hope you guys enjoy our little updates with Jessica. Last person I have to ask who their favorite animal is the birthday girl, Tina. So what is your favorite animal?
An otter.
Animal?
It's an otter. I love otters.
Oh, that's right.
They're super smart. A river otter. Not just any otter, a river otter.
A river otter. And river otters are absolutely amazing. They are super intelligent, but they're cheeky little monkeys. I gotta tell you, most of my zookeeper friends tell me that those little otters will lull you into a sense of security and then they'll bite you. And they're super smart. They're really good at escaping. They'll like actually use things like rocks to put in the door so that you think it's closed and then they get out. So river otters are absolutely amazing. They're a little bit feisty at times. So there you have it. Everyone's dream animal. All right, guys, so there you have it. The kind of update vlog of the day or whatever the case may be. It's been a really fun day and it's really cool to be back here as always. I'm in town for about another week, so it's gonna be awesome. And tonight me and Laura are gonna go out to the movie, so I am excited about it. So I am gonna wrap up the vlog here. I hope that you guys have an absolutely amazing day. Thank you so much for tuning in. You guys mean the world to me. Can you do me a couple favors? And you know what's coming. I'm gonna ask you to smash that like button. The more likes we get, the better our videos do, and that means a lot to me. Also, make sure to turn the post notifications on so you know when I upload a video, which is 9 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 7 days a week. You guys know that. Remember to be kind to somebody, and I promise I'm going to see you guys tomorrow.